Hello all, welcome back, thanks for the subs, comments and likes. I've had quite a busy week this week, so unfortunately I'm not going to be doing a lot of recording today. I can do a little bit, but not a lot, because of my storage on my phone. So yeah, I want to see if I can actually record this. I want to get my cauliflowers out. Yeah, as you can see, it's probably ready now, but two of them have come up blind. Yeah. So yeah, I'll do them and I'll show you my kohlrabi in a minute as well. These are my carrots, they're doing all right. I've had a look, but there's not a lot underneath at the moment, so we'll have to see how they go. As you can see, I've weeded now where the greenhouse was. Yeah. Because I was going to do a greenhouse base and cement base, it's got all kinds of rubble and stuff. Yeah, where I dug a trench around. It's even got it there, but it's been covered mostly with soil. But yeah, but because I was going to do a concrete base, it's got a trench there. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is take all that rubble out. Yeah, I'll have to re-dig that bit. And I'll have to dig it out a little bit further out. Then I'm gonna build my polytunnel frame, put the cover over, and then I'm gonna bury the cover, well, put the bricks on top of the cover so that it actually holds the cover down, then obviously put soil on the top. Yeah. But another quick note, I don't know whether YouTube messing about with the analytics on here, but my view count has really gone down quite a lot. Yeah, so if you can check on your subscribe and you've clicked on all, you'll get my notifications every time I upload. Right, this is my black currant. I need to move it, but as you can see, it started to grow again. So I don't know what's going on with that, but it died back. It gave me black currants already, and it died back and everything, and it started to regrow again. So I think it's because we had that sudden downpour of rain and stuff that it's spurted itself back into growth again. But really, I need to move this, and I need to move my gooseberry as well when it comes to the time. But yeah, I don't know whether I can do them or not now. So if you know, let me know down in the comments if I can move my gooseberry and my black currant that's started to regrow again for some unknown reason. Right, this is my spent compost from my potatoes earlier on in the year. Yeah, so I need to get that out of the wheelbarrow and onto that other bed that I'm going to do the onions in first. Right, I'm going to harvest my potatoes today, I think. Yeah, so I'll do one on camera, yeah, then I'll put you on time lapse for the rest of them, then I'll come back to you and I'll show you what I get at the end. But the spent compost from these potatoes I'm going to put on my new bed. Ooh, put on my new bed, yeah, ready for when I plant my onions out, because I'm going to put my onions on that bed.
That's the wheelbarrow load of spent compost put in there, yeah.
But yeah, so but I've got that up. I'm going to do the rest of the potatoes, then I'm going to put the rest of it on there, and that'll be my onion bed for next year. Right, I've moved my fabric pots now, yeah, and as you can see, there's a lot of moisture on the ground, which is good, which is where the old pots were, which is good. So obviously the pots that I'm growing my potatoes in are obviously holding the moisture, which is a good sign. So yeah, thumbs up for them fabric pots for me, definitely, as you can see. Thank you. Right, this is the Maris Pier, but all the other things have all been mixed up, yeah, so we'll see how we go. But this is the first one. I'm going to do this one, then I'll put you on time lapse for the rest of them. Look at the size of that thing. Look at the size of that worm. That's big. Blimey. Well, there you go. I'm not surprised that I didn't get very many, to be honest. But you got badly hit by slugs, so yeah. But I'll put you on a time lapse now and I'll do the rest. There you go, that's all I've got. But hey, they did get hit by slugs really bad in the beginning of the year, so I'm not surprised really. But I've got some nice Desiri. I've done quite well with these last year, yeah. So I don't know. I think it's because they got hit by the slugs really early on. It stunted their growth again. So I'll have to give them another go this next year. As you've just seen, I put all my, well, most of my potato compost on here now, so I'll spread that out and all that. But I want to save this barra because I want this barra to go into this bed. Once I get a bit of space in there, I can put that compost on this first bed. There you go, all the spent compost that I'm going to put in the bed for my onions is in there now. All leveled out and everything, yeah. So really it's just ready for the onions to go in when I'm ready to do them. So yeah, we'll see how that goes. Right, as you can see, I've ended up with a bit of scab on my potato, but it's not the end of the world. It's only a little bit. Most of them are fine. It's just the odd one or two that's got a little bit on, yeah. But I've got it on that other Ziri. But the Maris Pier seems to be a little bit worse off, to be honest. But hey, it's not the end of the world. I'll just cut that bit off and then I'll eat the rest. But I thought I'd just show you that. Cheers. Right, it's Tuesday, 1st of September. As you can see, I've put some scaffold netting on my new bed, yeah, because there's a lot of cats around here and they seem to like it as a cat litter tray. So yeah, I've just put that on there, hoping to keep them things off of there from doing their business on it. But also, as you can see, I've sorted out my bits of wood that I'm going to keep. Sorry about the shadow. As you can see, I've kept the bits of wood that I'm going to keep there. And I've got a little bit of a burning thing over there. Yeah, that's just the rubbish that I'm going to burn in the burning bin. But obviously I'm going to move the net before anybody says anything, yeah.
Right, these are my runner beans. I'm getting a few runners on it, yeah, but I think I'm gonna more or less give up the ghost on these things, yeah, and just save the seeds, because I've got a black fly coming back again, yeah. So I'm probably just gonna let them do whatever they do, yeah. Obviously I've got some, so yeah, I'm probably just gonna save this seed for next year and start again next year, because like I say, they didn't have a very good start. There is quite a lot of flowers on this end one, so we'll see how many we get on that one. But overall, not really very good, to be honest. Not like last year. But hey, we'll see how they go. But they are starting to flower up and bunch up and do what they do. But yeah. As I said before, I only got one runner from my strawberries, which I'm quite surprised. So all I'm going to do is just dig a hole, plop that in like that. Still got the cord attached, yeah, but we'll see. Once it grows a bit more, then obviously I'll cut the cord thing off, yeah. But yeah, that's the only runner so far. So I'm probably not going to get very many this year. But hey, I wasn't expecting that one, to be honest. So that's a bonus. Right, this is the trug I've got my pine berries in, but as you can see, they've all finished. Well, they've died back and I've cut the tops off and everything, yeah. But there is pine berries in there. Didn't have very many this year, but hey, we'll see what happens next year when they come up. Hopefully I'll have a few more next year than I did this year. But it looks empty, but there is pine berries in there. Right, these are my shallots from this year, so I'm going to let them dry out and everything, yeah, and I'm going to plant them again when it's time to come this year. But it's only a little experiment. I don't know whether anything will happen with them, whether they grow more shallots or not or anything, but yeah, I'm going to give it a go, and if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, then it's not the end of the world. It's just to see if you can grow them on the next year more than anything else. Right, as you can see, I've built the front bit of the bed of number three. But as you can see, it goes right through the gooseberries, yeah. I'm going to have to move that because I want, it's roughly in line with the tree stump. And I want a little bit of a gap so I can get down the edges, yeah. So I'll need to move the gooseberry and the blackcurrant before I can build any more of the bed. Right, I'm a bit unsure whether to record this and let you see it or not, because I don't know whether you'll be interested or not. So I thought I'd give it a go, and you can let me know down in the comments or not. But this is a rambling rose that I've got out the front. As you can see, I've cut the hedge already, yeah? But this is a rambling rose. I'm going to take some of these top growth out. As you can see, it's got lots of berries on it for the birds when they want to take them or not, but I need to take these big shoots off, so I'll put you on a time lapse and let you watch that. There you go. All done. Didn't take very long, but most of it was from next door because they don't want it growing over the drive, so I had to do it from their side. But yeah, but this is what I took off. Quite a lot, to be honest, but the branches were really thick and it's only like a year's growth, so yeah. But hey, looks better. Right, this is my bare-rooted rambling rose I put in the beginning of the year. It's doing all right, it's not too bad. But yeah, quite a lot of growth, but it needs tying in, yeah? Because the idea of this is to have the rambling rose grow up the top there and all the way across the top, yeah? So then that'd be all white flowers all the way along the top there with that rambling rose. I have got another rambling rose here in the middle that isn't doing so well. But yeah, it'll get there eventually. Yeah, it'll just grow up the top there, along the top there again, yeah. So there'll be white roses at the top there as well. I did have one at the other end, at this end, but it didn't make it, it died off. So yeah, but hey, I'll have to bloody weed this lot as well. By the looks of it, it's got quite bad. But hey, oh, these are the irises. I think that are irises that I got from work. They're doing all right. Bit of yellowing off, but nothing really to worry about. They're doing fine. Like I just said, these have got a little bit of die back, but it's not the end of the world. But you can actually cut these, yeah. Just take the top off like that, and it, all that's going to do is then it's going to concentrate on growing roots instead of growing the leaves. Yeah, I'll do half of them, then we'll come back later on when they've started growing, and you can see the difference between the cut and the not cut. Because obviously, I'll show you the roots and what have you afterwards. Yeah, there you go. Right, as you can see now, I've cut the leaves off of half of them, yeah. Later on in the year, when they start growing, I'll take them out of the pots. I'll take one out that's been cut and one that hasn't, and we'll see the difference. But my money's on the one that's been cut that's going to have a better root system, because it's not concentrating on growing leaves now, yeah. All it wants to do is just put roots down, so... we'll see what happens. I'll show you later on in the year the difference in the root ball. Right, this is my red kohlrabi. And as you can see, it is growing quite well, but it's still not quite big enough. So I'm probably going to leave it another week or two. We'll see how they go. But they're not quite big enough yet. They're still quite small. So... yeah, unfortunately it's not going to be 2 weeks, it's probably going to be another week at least, I would have thought. Depends on the weather, I suppose. If we get more rain, then that'll make them swell up even better, won't it? But they're not quite ready at the moment, so yeah, they're going to be another week at least. Right, I've taken my cauliflower out now, and just like I thought, this is the mutant cauliflower, yeah. It's just starting to form a head in the middle. So yeah, just like I thought, it didn't really come to nothing, but it did start forming a head. Whereas this other one did absolutely nothing. So yeah, that's total waste. But I did get one cauliflower, not the best, but hey, it's my first cauliflower I've grown, so I can't really moan. But that's gonna be it for this week. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you later. Bye.